One of my YouTube subscriber asked me about how to build a pie cone in the Rhino 3D software. So I decided to build a tutorial to show you the step-by-step process of how to build this pie cone. Hi, I'm PJ Chen, an authorized Rhino trainer. Let's get started. To build this pie cone in Rhino 3D software, we will need following command. First, we are going to use the curve to build the basic structure on one of the element here. Then we will use the curve from two view to creating the curve for the surface. Then we will use the curve network command to creating the surface. Once we create one element, we will just need to rotate and copy. And we create many layers. On the top of a layer is bigger and the bottom is smaller, so we're gonna use the scale and cage edit to edit it. Let's go to Google and search for pie cone image. You will see there's a lot of the shape here. Most likely you will see some sort of a structure like triangle-ish at the head and it's kind of tapered to the center. The sheer really similar structure, let's take a look on this one. Once you make one of the element, then you will use the polar array command and then having one layer. After you have the first layer, then you will just rotate and copy, then size them in different sizes. Let's start from the top view. So we're gonna use the curve tool and we try to draw creating the first element there. What I try to do is create some sort of triangle-ish shape, and you can also use the control point. You can turn on the control point and add it to until you feel like the form it will fit what you want. After that, I'll just simply mirror to the other side. If you like it really organic look, it doesn't have to be symmetrical. Then I will use the trim tool to trim off the extra. While they are selected, I would like to round this corner a little bit. So the command you're gonna use is fillet curve. Let's set up the radius to 1 on the command bar, hit enter. Then you pick up this curve and that curve, and then it's kind of rounded. So we got that first profile on the top view. If you are looking at this individual component, you will see then they have kind of a curvature there. So I'm going to move it out one of the layer, making a copy here. And then let's take a look. I was basically just group them. So I'm going to ungroup them and just pick one of them and delete the rest of it. So by deconstructed, you know what I did is I make one part and mirror to the other side and kind of blend in the middle and work on the bottom part to close it to make it solid. Let's go back with this curve. Now this curve is flat. So what we need to do is to creating a curve from the front view. So let's just simply draw a curve. I'm gonna use the arc tool. I'm gonna click on 2 points and kind of getting in like this. Let me enlarge the front view. And you can turn on the control point to edit to make the curve into more of the curvature that you like. The command we are going to use, let's go to the perspective view. The command we are going to use is curve from two view. So make sure we join all the curve first. And then we want to use the command is leaving under the curve. You have this icon here is curve from two views. It will ask you to pick out the first curve and the second curve. I'm going to turn this new curve into the red color so you will see better. Now we no longer need this original curve, I'm just gonna hide it. And then on the front view, what I like to do is to draw a curve starting from this quadrant and to kind of giving a profile of how I like it on the side view. And again, we can turn on the control point to edit. If you don't have enough control point, what you can do is you can insert one more control point. So if you go into the point edit, you have the option to edit the point. For example, you want to add one here. And so that way that gives you more control point to edit. So we kind of edit into the way we want it. And let's take a look on the perspective view. The hotkey for changing the view is F4, control F4. Then you will get into the perspective quickly. We want to use the arc tool to creating a profile. So let's go with this start and end point on arc. Snapping into this endpoint, and this endpoint. So to create an arc that is touching all three curves. Don't forget to split this one on the bottom by the black curve. So now we have the curve individually. The command we're using living under the surface. Then you have curve network. You're going to pick in the order of 1, 2, 3 and the profile here. So you will get the surface like this. Now, what you can also do, that's undo. Before we do the curve network, we can hit the record history on the bottom. Then we'll do the same thing, curve network, and we'll go UUU and the cross section. And they look like nothing different, but if we turn on the control point of the curve in the middle, then while we are edit our control point, the surface will follow. So you can kind of get the lifetime changing here to edit the surface. Let's say we really like this surface. Let's get out all the command. And I would like to creating the straight line on the bottom. This time I want to use the sweep tool. So go to the surface, sweep to rail. This is your rail one, and that's your rail two. And this will be the cross section. So we can close the bottom. So let's join them. It will say that break the history once you join, but that's okay since we are not going to change the surface anymore. So now we finish one part of it. Next step, we will need to mirror this guy. So let's select all the curve and just temporarily to hide it because we don't need it anymore. Let's moving this one to the right side a little bit. And I do like it to having more curve first. Then let's use the mirror to mirror to the other side. So once we mirror it, we can do is to use the blend tool. You're going to blend from this surface to this surface. And once we finish, we can either blend that as well, or we can use a sweep tool, either one. So we're gonna use the blend tool again, blending from this edge to that edge as well. Okay, so once everything's done, let's join them. We need to rotate this guy about every 30 degrees, but look like it's kind of blocking, or it's like, touching each other. So what I like to do is do the 1D scale first so they are a little bit more elongated. Then I'm going to use the rotate tool, center type is 0, enter. And then every 30 degrees, And then it is still touching, but at least it's not overlapping too much. So every 30 degree increasement, I'm going to make a copy. So that's 90, 120 degree, and 150 degree. So then I have this shape. Let's take a look on the perspective. Once you got everything, make sure you group them, or you can go ahead and boolean unit it. So now we have one layer. Let's take a look on the Google image. This is the pine cone image on the Google. So the good looking one, it looked like it almost like an egg. It's just upside down for what the direction we are going for. So let's go back to the Rhino. And what I like to do is, if we go on the top view, I'm going to Control C, that means copy, and Control V to copy and paste the same object at the same place. Okay, and I'm going to move this up a little bit so you can see there actually are two objects. Since at the beginning we were doing this every 30 degrees, so I'm going to rotate for 15 degree, hit enter, and then you are going to see they are like 15 degree apart. And on this one, I actually need to make it smaller, so I'm going to scale it down a little bit more and bring up a little bit more. If you need this look thicker, you can actually scale 1D to make it thicker. So if we take a look on the render, we're going to get some shape like this. Okay, so I'm going to fast forward here to finish all the layer up and down, and then you can watch me in a faster speed. What I'm doing here is moving the component up, and while it's using the gumbo to move up, I hit the Alt key, so that's how I make a copy. Each of the copy, I will rotate it 15 degrees and then keep moving up to get the shape that I want. Now I'm going to move it down, and at the same time, I'm holding the Shift key on the gumbo scale tool so I can scale them in 3D. If you need to make them thicker, you can do is to use the gumbo and then scale 1D, which is dragging one of the square, and then that way will help you to only go on 1D instead of 3D. Again, if you're holding the Shift and drag any of the square, and then you are doing 3D scaling. So I'm about to finish here to the very last one. On the very bottom here, I would like to use another command. It's called cage edit. So we type it here, cage edit. What it does, it's going to build a bounding box. So click on the bounding box on the command bar. And then you hit enter. It will ask you X, Y, Z, how many points you want. At the preset, you have 4, 4, and 4 for X, Y, Z. So once you click enter, you will come up a box, you will come up with this control point. And the reason we want to do that is sometimes I did not want to keep getting thicker, I just want them to come closer. So you can choose all the button point, and then you can use the scale tool to scale it down. So that way it will come in down a little bit more. And maybe where's on the second half of the point, and I want to scale it down again. So this piece is more like close to the on the bottom. Okay. Once you are done, hit escape, and then you can delete this bounding box, and let's turn on the rest of the layer. So it looks like it's coming down together. Alright, and at the end, what I need to do is put the post in the middle, if you want to cast this, this is for the rendering purpose. If you do want to cast it, you may want to consider the thickness and everything and have a post right in the middle to connect all of them. And making this post is quite easy. We just need to have a straight curve, straight line, and we'll go ahead and pipe it using the pipe tool here. Once I've done it, we can look at the perspective. We can just move it, this guy, to the center. And then the easiest way to move is you can go on the top view. You can pick up any layer and also this post. Let's use the align tool to align right at the zero point. So it will come to the center. So now the post is right in there. Some of it might, like for example, this might need to kind of come in down, scale it down a little bit, and you can tweak it into the shape that you want. So let's take a look on the render. This is will be our pine cone. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and share my video that helped me to create more tutorial for you. See you next Monday. Leave a comment to tell me what you like to learn about Rhino 3D, and I will do my best to make a video for you.